The prisoner's dilemma is one example of something game theory studies. Let's assume A and B are called duty wallet. Game theory assumes they are both rational and self-interested. The regular punishment for what they did is 1 year in jail each. However, let's assume the police expect one of them was involved in a more serious effect. So let's assume the police expect one of them was involved in a more serious effect. A is offered a deal by the police as he testifies against B for more serious crime, but B doesn't testify against him. He gets zero jail time, but B gets 8 years jail. B gets the same offer. If none of them testifies, each person only gets 1 year in jail. If both of them testify, they get 3 years each. Obviously, it seems in their best interest that neither of them testifies is only 2 years of total jail time, with the result one for each. However, let's look at things from A's perspective. He got two tries, testify B or not. A that he doesn't testify against B, he got two outcomes, one in which he gets 1 year and one which he gets 8. A then sees that if he testifies, he had to get zero jail time or 3 years. Testify therefore seems more appealing. The same thing goes for B. Game theory therefore predicts that both of these rational self-interested people would end up testifying and receive 3 years each. As a whole, both participants find themselves in a worse condition than if they had cooperated with each other in the decision-making process. Please note, however, that various real-world experiments have proven people are more inclined to cooperate than this model would indicate. I'm Henry Lee. Thanks for watching.